I'm here with Rachel Baranick with the SBA. Rachel, can you tell me, events like this week's summit here in San Bernardino, how important it is to bring people together?
Well, I think an event like this, especially during these economic times, is crucial. Because I think it assesses the needs of the community, the business community. It brings together resources for the community, as well as different types of workshops that are available to them. I think it's good to inform, educate, and connect the community with the various resources and the various vendors that are out here, and for them just to be well-informed about what's out there for them.
And what role does the Small Business Administration serve in the quality life scheme?
Well, obviously the Small Business Administration stresses its programs to small businesses. And actually you might ask, what is a small business? And I've had that asked of me many times. It's actually could range from a mom and pop situation to a manufacturing company that has 500 employees or a construction company that has revenues of over $33.5 million. So the SBA obviously is an advocate for small business. We provide the three C's, which is counseling to small businesses, capital, money, loans for small businesses to start and grow their businesses, as well as assistance with contracting, and that is government contracting, mostly federal contracting.
What are some of the challenges you think not only your organization faces, but the businesses that you assist?
I think a lot of the challenges are deal with access to capital. Loan production went down significantly last year, but I'm happy to say that it's on an uptick, especially the first quarter of our fiscal year, which is October through December. We had a significant increase in SBA loans going out to those small businesses. Actually, in the Inland Empire, there was an increase of 30% compared to the same quarter last year. So I think things are looking up, and access to capital definitely is a crucial need for small businesses. But in addition to that, they need to be well prepared. And so that's where our resources come in. The Small Business Development Center, the Women's Business Center, SCORE, they all provide technical and management assistance to small business owners, who want to grow their business or even want to start a business.
Are you optimistic? Do you think there's signs that the economy is recovering, and are you optimistic for the future?
Yes, absolutely. I tend to be an optimist anyway, but I am very optimistic as far as the economy. As I said, our loan production has gone up significantly. Government contracting has gone up significantly, and I don't know if the public is aware of that, but our federal government has a goal of setting aside 23% of federal contract dollars to small businesses. So there's definitely opportunities for small businesses, especially in the Inland Empire, to do business with the government.
What role do you think organizations like the Inland Empire Economic Partnership fill in this region? How important do you think, they put on this event, but what other roles do you think they should take?
Well, I think the key is the economy. Along with that is creating and retaining jobs. I think bringing businesses to the Inland Empire, where real estate is relatively, cheap right now, is important. I think the organization can also provide education and training to business owners, to individuals about the resources that are out there. So bringing everyone together in the Inland Empire, I think, is key, because you face that Orange County, elephant.
Right.
And then having, the Inland Empire just as a conglomerate, a collaborative effort to bring all those organizations together and the businesses together, I think is key for the economy in the Inland Empire.
And what would you hope to see accomplished in today's event?
I think people should walk away with enough information to take that next step, and especially as businesses, as far as businesses are concerned, how to grow their businesses, and if they haven't started a business, maybe to have a roadmap of where to go next on how to start that business. And that all goes with, retaining and creating jobs, and that's key right now, especially with the unemployment as high as it is.